Saya Nur Syahidah Jamsari dalam Duit, dimensi berorientasikan inovasi dan teknologi yang sentiasa memaparkan dunia keusahawanan dan inovasi untuk tontonan anda. Baiklah, sebelum itu, apa kata kita lihat segmen-segmen menarik paparan Duit minggu ini. Kejadian gempa bumi di Ranau Sabah yang berlaku pada 6 skala Richter bukan sahaja mengorbankan nyawa, malah menyebabkan kerugian harta benda yang bernilai. Apakah yang dapat kita lakukan sebagai persediaan untuk menghadapi situasi ini? Kupasannya dalam Detek.
Dianggarkan lebih 1 bilion manusia di seluruh dunia terdedah kepada ancaman gempa bumi pada hari ini. Malaysia juga tidak terkecuali. Kejadian gempa bumi di Sabah pada 2015 dengan gegaran berskala 6 Richter jelas menjadi titik tolak kepada perlunya kesiapsiagaan yang lebih baik bagi Malaysia sendiri dalam berdepan dengan bencana alam. Selain mencegah lebih banyak nyawa yang terkorban, kepentingan meningkatkan kestabilan dan kekuatan struktur bangunan di negara ini juga amat perlu. Ini kerana walaupun Malaysia berada di luar lingkaran api Pasifik, kebarangkalian Malaysia untuk dilanda gempa bumi pada masa hadapan tetap ada dan ia diakui oleh penyelidik tempatan. Sehubungan itu, bagi meningkatkan kestabilan dan kekuatan struktur bangunan, peranti dinding penampan gegaran telah dibangunkan oleh sekumpulan penyelidik dari Universiti Putra. Malaysia, UPM. Kajian selama 10 tahun itu diketuai sendiri oleh Dr. Farzad Hejazi, pensyarah Jabatan Kejuruteraan Awam Fakulti Kejuruteraan UPM. Pengalaman berdepan dengan tragedi gempa bumi di tanah air beliau menjadi titik tolak kepada usaha membangunkan peranti penampan gempa ini.
I experienced the some earthquake in Iran, which during that earthquake which happened in 2003, 40,000 of the people they lost their life. And it was a very huge disaster at that time. That's why I was thinking about the, how we can protect the structure to guarantee the safety of the building and increase the safety and stability of the building and protect of the people's life against some natural disasters such as the earthquake, tsunami. That's why this thinking started.
Turut sama dalam pembangunan peranti ini adalah rakan beliau, Muhammad Azmi Muhammad Zain dan Amir Fateh dari UPM. Uniknya, peranti yang dibangunkan bukan sahaja menggunakan bahan mentah tempatan pada kos yang rendah dan berkualiti, malah dicipta khas bagi digunakan untuk mana-mana struktur, melibatkan bangunan, rumah kediaman, jejantas, jejambat maupun jambatan gantung. Sebanyak 5 jenis prototip peranti dihasilkan sebagai penampan gegaran. Pertama adalah penampan dinding getah atau wall rubber damper, dinding likat atau viscous wall damper. Ketiga, penampan penyambung atau damper connector. Keempat, perembatan spring conical non-linear atau non-linear conical spring bracing. Dan akhir sekali, variable stiffness bracing system atau sistem kejang boleh ubah.
Based on the criteria of the structure, we developed the 5 different devices. This device is applicable for low intensity of the earthquake, but also is applied, is able to function to the high intensity of the earthquake. In general, this device is able to reduce the vibration effect in the structure around 50% up to 70%. So in this case, we are able to ensure about the stability of the structure and the safety of the building during the natural hazards such as the earthquake. But one of the application is only in the structure, but it also is able to implement in the bridge, also is able to implement in the train stations because we have just train vibration, even in the normal structure in the parking because of the vibration in the vehicles.
Secara purata, kos penampan ini hanyalah 1/3 daripada kos produk yang seumpamanya yang dikeluarkan di Amerika Syarikat dan Jepun. Kesemua peranti ciptaan Dr. Farzad ini telah dipatenkan dan dalam peringkat pengkomersilan. Bagi memastikan kesesuaian peranti bagi sesuatu struktur pula, Dr. Farzad turut membangunkan perisian khas.
Before the construction of the structure, we have to make sure is this device is work in the structure or not? Is it reduce the vibration effect or not? That's why we think about that. We have to develop some tools for new medical modeling and simulations by using of the any software of the structure equipped with our developed device. That's why we just developed some special software. This software is give possibility to any user to define and model the structure, new structure to be built, or even the existing structure, we can do the model with using of the software. It's very user-friendly. Our cost, our developed device cost in comparison of the cost of the similar device in the market is only 50% up to 70% less. So because we use the very simple raw material, only the steel and the rubber, which is available in the Malaysia, and the rubber in the Malaysia is have very high quality and the price is very nice and cheap in comparison of the other similar materials such as a high viscosity, which is too expensive in the worldwide. And we try to just use the same performance. We try to just reach the same performance with low cost. That's why we got some interest from the US, Canada, and the Japan. Also, we look about the good market in the earthquake prone zone area, which is in the Middle East. We got a lot of the good interest from the some company in Iran and the Turkey, which is the high prone zone area for the earthquake. And our device price in there is very economic to implement in the structure.
Kejayaan menghasilkan kesemua 5 peranti ini turut membolehkan Dr. Farzad meraih pelbagai pengiktirafan dari dalam dan luar negara. Sehubungan itu, beliau kini berusaha keras dalam mempromosikan peranti yang dibangunkan.
So our market strategy, we are not looking about the only local market. In the local market in the Sabah, Sarawak, we look about the how we just sell the our product in the Sabah, Sarawak for the just normal building, residential building, because the prices, economy is not too expensive to use in the conventional building. Also, we look about the selling of our product in the international market, in the Middle East, in US, and also in the Japan. And how we can just win to the in compare of our competitors because of our price is too low and the quality, we have the same performance.
Malaysia, Nur Hayati Tasli mengkomersilkan pabrik tenunan ikat Indonesia buat penggemar seumpamanya di negara ini. Jenama Maikat